अरे वाह, लैंग्वेज बुक का
अलीना यही क्लास है हम ना की वीडियो नजर आ रही है मुझे. हेलो, व्हाट डू यू नो उर्दू का जल्दी. टीचर कहाँ पर?
पार्टिसिपेंट्स आना शुरू होंगे. पार्टिसिपेंट्स एनोटेशन सिक्योरिटी में हम जाएंगे.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. I'm Mrs. Afreen Imran, your English teacher. Today we are going to start our online classes. But before my lecture, I want to discuss some things with you. You all know that coronavirus pandemic has been spreading all over the world, and many people have been attacked by that pandemic. You know that it is fatal. It means many people are died due to that pandemic, and it is spreading continuously. The death rate is also very high. So we all have to take some precautionary measures. You should be aware of all that, like we should use masks and gloves, stay neat and clean, wash our hands many times for 20 seconds, use sanitizers, and use the tissue for coughing and sneezing, and after the use, discard it immediately. One more thing, the most important, to maintain the social distance. For all these reasons, you know that for coronavirus pandemic, our academics has been stopped because all the schools have been shut down for the unlimited period of time. Therefore, our school management has decided to start the online classes so that your academics will be continued. Now, before starting my today's lecture, I want to welcome you all and congratulate you as you have been promoted to secondary section. Now, welcome you all for class 6. You all know that when we come to secondary section, that is class 6, we start the use of fountain pen. That means you have to practice to write everything with the fountain pen. First of all, one more thing I want to discuss, some rules. We have already uploaded them in the Google Classroom. I think you have read it, but I want to discuss some most important of them. That when you join our online classes, you will have to join with your real name, that is your ID, that is your roll number, which has been given to you with your result packs. So please remember this roll number by heart as well. And whenever you join our online classes, you should be there with your real ID. Another rule which has to be applied here, it is that because today is the first session, so we are giving you the chances to join us for the whole session anytime, at any time. But after that, from the next session, we will allow you only 10 minutes to join our class. After that, we will not allow you to join our class. Kindly stop sharing your videos, please. Turn off your cameras. Thanks. Thanks a lot. One more thing which I want to discuss before the start of the lecture, that you are not allowed to leave the classroom before our permission. It means if you have any problem, particular problem, then you will inform us first and leave for a while. After that, you will be allowed to join again. Otherwise, if you are leaving the classroom without information, we will not allow you to continue again and you will miss your lecture. So please be very cooperative, attentive, so that you will understand everything more clearly. And one more thing, we are discussing about your home assignments. after the end of each and every lecture, we'll give you some home assignments to do. But we will upload them in your Google Classroom. So you should be there at every time to check whenever the home assignments will be uploaded. You have to been given some particular time to complete those assignments, and there is a date to submit your assignments. So you should be very attentive for that and punctual, because you will be marked some grades. We'll give you some grades for doing the work in very appropriate forms. This lecture video will also be uploaded in the YouTube channel. You will get it from there so that you will recall all the things which I am giving you in the lecture. So that if anything is missed, because it is the first lecture, so you can get it from that upload. So please be attentive, be punctual, be regular, and be very much cooperative with us. Now again, welcome you in the class 6, and many, many congratulations for coming in the secondary section. I am Mrs. Afshin Imran, your English teacher. We are doing, or I am giving you a lecture of English language today. Now, first of all, I'm discussing you, or I'm showing you your textbook and the exercise book. Here you can see that it is your textbook. It is concept one, a secondary English course. I think many of you have already purchased it. This is your copy. You can take it from your school. It is English side, single line copy, and it contains 300 pages. An important note is written here. So please be careful about this. Write your roll number on the top of your copy. That is your exercise book. Roll number we have already provided to you with the result packs. So you should keep in mind that it is the most important thing for the continuation of online classes. Next, when you open your copy, you will find the index page. There are many columns. You can see that serial number, date, topic, teacher sign, and parent sign. But these are only three columns you can fill here whenever you get the assignments, and you will do them according to the date. You should fill it date wise according to the topic very neatly. Next page after the index, you will find a single line page, and it is used for making the title. Like the first topic which we will be discussing after some time, it is parts of speech. So the first title will be parts of speech. You can make the title with the black pen and very neatly and clearly. Now I'm going to start my lecture one. The topic is parts of speech. You have done this topic before many times so that you can understand it very clearly, but I'm repeating it again with the definitions and examples. You can see that there are 9 parts of speech in all. These are actually the words which we use when we write something or when we talk something, we use them in different ways. These are 9 in number: noun, verb, pronoun, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection, and there is a 9th one, that is articles. So we are discussing them one by one in detail. their definitions and examples. I'm giving you. The first one is noun. A noun is a name of a person, place, animal, or thing. You all know that noun is actually a naming word, and it is the name given to any person, any place, any animal, or anything. There are some examples which I have given here for person, place, animal, and thing. Like you can see, Ali. Ali is a person. You can write or you can use any name as an example of a noun for a person, like Sarah, like your own name, like my name. Next is Karachi, the place. Any other place, like a school, like park, like river. Next is, the example is of an animal, lion, cat, dog. Next example is of chair. That is the example of thing. Chair, table, clock, window. I have given some examples in the form of the sentences so that you can understand the use of these nouns in sentences. Ali is a good boy. You can see that I have underlined the nouns here so that you can understand easily. Ali, the name of a person, so it is a noun. Then boy, a name, it is a person, so it is a noun. He's a person. In the next example, Sarah goes to school by bus. There are three nouns in the sentence. Sarah, person, school, place, bus, thing. Next is, my school is very big. Here you can see that school is a place, so it is a noun. Pakistan is a world dearest country. That is, Pakistan is a place, it is a noun. Country is a place, so it is a noun. I respect my elders. Elders, these are persons, so it is also a noun. Now we come to the next part of speech, that is verb. A verb is a word which shows an action. Simply, you can say that verb is an action word. Some examples here are eat, drink, read, and write. You can see that all these examples are actually the words which show some actions. And because of that, these are called the verbs. Examples are here in the sentence forms. Ahmed reads a lesson. Sana learns a poem. He walks on the road. She prepares meal for the guest. They play cricket. Kindly turn off your videos. Now here you can see in the examples, all the underlined words are verbs, as these all show actions. Reads, learns, walks, prepares, play. Now we come to the third part of the speech, that is pronoun. A pronoun is a word which is used in place of a noun. Here you can see that a pronoun is actually the word which is used in place of a noun. In some cases, whenever we write something about some particular person, we can't repeat his name again and again because it looks odd and it is not the way to write anything about some person. Like I'm giving you an example here. Ali is a boy. Ali is active. Ali is hardworking. Ali is intelligent. You can see when I repeat the name of Ali, it doesn't look nice. So in those cases, we replace the name of the person with a pronoun, like he. Ali is a boy, he is active, he is hardworking, he is intelligent. I think you are understanding very clearly. Some examples are here. He, it is used for the male persons. She, used for the female persons. We is used for more than one person. It means when we have two or three persons or more than one person, we use the word we as a pronoun. Then the word they for more than one person. They is another word or another pronoun which is used for more than one person. Now there are some examples in the sentences form. He wrote a letter. She cleans the room. We are going to museum. You are telling a story. They were throwing balls. You can see that all the underlined words are pronouns as they are replacing some names or some nouns. Now, another part of speech is adjective. An adjective is a word which tells something about a noun or a pronoun. It is actually called a describing word because it tells more about a noun or a pronoun and describes them very easily. Like some of the words which are used as adjectives are beautiful, active, cold, and enough here. Now you can see these words here, which I have given in the examples. These are used to describe a noun or a pronoun. So these are called adjectives. Some examples in the sentence form are given here. Ahmed is a very kind man. Turn off your video, please, Marusha. Ahmed is a very kind man. You can see that kind is a word which is describing that man, that Ahmed is very kind. Next is Sara is an intelligent student. Now the word intelligent is describing Sara, that how much intelligent she is. Next is the flower is beautiful. Beautiful is the describing word which describes the flower, that it is very beautiful. He tells an interesting story. Interesting is describing the story. She wore red dress. Red, you can see that it is a color, but it is a describing word here because it shows the quality of the dress, or you can say the color of the dress. Next is adverb. An adverb is a word which tells something about a verb. It means it is a describing word which describes or tells more about a verb. Some examples here are fast, early, sometimes, nearly. Some examples in the sentences forms are Aisha walks slowly. You can see that slowly is a word which is describing the walk of Aisha. And so it is an adverb. Ali came early in the morning. That means Ali came early. So early is a describing word. That is an adverb here. The kitchen is downstairs. Downstairs is the word which shows the place of kitchen. Here you can see that another example, they will meet us soon. Soon is the word which is describing that meeting will be starting soon or they will meet us soon. The children work hard. Work is the word which describes that children were doing very hard work. Next is preposition. The most important thing here is to pronounce the word correctly. It is not preposition. The actual pronunciation is preposition. So please keep it in mind. A preposition is a word which is used before a noun or a pronoun to show its relation with another word. It means it is a word which is showing a relation between a noun or a pronoun with another word in the sentence. Some examples are with, from, into, behind. I'm using some of the prepositions in the sentences, like the teacher is writing with a pen. You can see here, I have underlined the preposition with here. With is showing the relation between a pen and the writing of the teacher. Next is the frog jumped into the pond. That means into is the word that is a preposition. It describes the relation between the pond and the jumping of the frog. Next is the patient died of cancer. Again, the preposition of, it is showing the relation between cancer and the death of the patient here. There is a park near my house. Near is the word that is a preposition which is showing the relation between the house and the park. He is suffering from fever. From is a word here which is describing the relation between fever and the patient who is suffering from the fever. Now, another part of the speech is conjunction. A conjunction is a word which joins two words or sentences. You can say it in the simple form that it is a joining word. There are some examples of conjunctions which are used for joining the sentences, like and, but, because, although. These are some of the examples which I have given you and used as a conjunction. Now, some examples in the sentences forms are, she sold her car and bought a new one. You can see here, these are actually two sentences. She sold her car, the first sentence. She bought a new one. This is the second sentence. And these are joined by the word and. So here in this example, and is a conjunction. Next example, he asked me a question, but I did not answer him. That means, again, there are two sentences. He asked me a question. Next sentence is, I did not answer him. These two are joined by the word but. So, but is a conjunction here. Next is, they might come or not come to school. It means there are two sentences. They might come, they might not come to school. We join them by a word or, which is a conjunction. Next sentence is, Ali did not come because he was ill. That means again two sentences are joined by the word because. Next example is, Sana answered all questions although she did not attend the class. Now you can see here again two sentences, Sana answered all questions. The other sentence is, she did not attend the class. These two sentences are joined by the word although. Next is interjection. Interjection is a word which shows sudden feelings. You all know that whenever we see something unusual or hear some shocking news or maybe something happens to us, we show some feelings, some sudden feelings. And we start or show our feelings by some words. Hurrah, wow, alas, oh. These are the words which are used as interjections, but these do not have any particular meaning. These are just showing some feelings. Like you can see in the example, that hurra is showing the feeling of happiness. Hurra, I have got first position. Next example is wow. That is also showing a feeling of excitement. That wow, the meal is very delicious. Alas, the patient has died. It is showing the feeling of sadness. Oh, I forgot my copy. Again, it shows the feeling of sadness. Ah, my friend has lost her parents. Again, you can see that. Ah, is the word which is showing the feeling of sadness. Now, I think you have understood till here very clearly. There is another part of a speech, the last one, which is articles. There are actually two kinds of articles. Indefinite article, which are of two kinds, A and N. Next is definite article, which is actually the. Marusha, turn off your video, please. I'm discussing the uses of these articles one by giving some examples. Use of indefinite article A. We are discussing the use of indefinite article A first. There are two uses. The first one is A is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant. I think you all have heard about the consonant words, that all the alphabets of the English letters other than vowels all are consonants. That means there are 21 consonants in English alphabets. So whenever a singular noun beginning with a consonant, we use a before that. Like in the example, you can see that I purchased a new car. You can see that the article A is used before a word starting with a consonant, that is N. Next example, we take a glass of milk daily. Again, you see that the article A is used before the word which is starting with a consonant G. Next use of the indefinite article A is that it is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel which has a consonant sound. It means A is also used with some vowels, but they should have the consonant sound. Like, she studied in a university. You can see that university is a word, it starts with a vowel, but it gives a consonant sound, like from U, university. You can see that it shows the sound of Y. Next example is, he is a European. Like, you can see that European, the word starts with a vowel, but it gives the sound of a consonant, that is Y again. Now we come to the use of indefinite article N. N is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel. You know that there are five vowels, A, E, I, O, U. So we always use N before a singular noun whenever it starts with a vowel. Like examples, my friend takes an egg in breakfast. You can see that egg is the word which starts with the vowel E, and before that I have inserted an article here, N, because it starts with the vowel E. Next is, there is an ink pot on the table. You can see here that ink pot, it starts with I, that is a vowel, so I use N before it. Abdullah Irfan, please turn off your video. Next is, N is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant which has a vowel sound. So you can see that and is also used with some consonant words, but they should give the vowel sound. Like you can see in the example, she is an MA in English. Here you can see that MA. MA, M is actually a consonant, but it gives the sound of a vowel, that is A. So I use the article and before it. Next is, he is an MSc in chemistry. Again, you see that MSc is a star. It starts with the consonant, but it gives the sound of a vowel, that is M, A, which starts with A. Now we come to the use of definite article. There is only one definite article, which is the. There are two uses mostly for the definite article the. Here you can see the first use, the is used before a proper noun. You all know that proper nouns are actually the names of particular persons and places. It means we give the particular name to the persons or places. So we use the definite article before it. In the example, you can see that I read the Daily Dawn. Here you can see that one more thing which you keep in mind, that whenever we write a proper noun, we always write their name with the capital letter, start with the capital letter. Like here you can see that I have written the name of Daily Dawn with the capital D. So I have written here the definite article the before the proper noun. I read the Daily Dawn. In the next example, you can see that the Mediterranean Sea is sometimes rough. You can see that Mediterranean Sea is a proper noun, that a particular name has been given to this sea. So we use the definite article the before Mediterranean Sea. There is another use of the definite article the. The is used before superlative degree of adjective. I think you know about the degrees of adjectives. There are 3 degrees: positive, comparative, and superlative. So the is used with the superlative degree. Like I'm giving you an example: thick, thicker, thickest. So thickest is the superlative degree here. So we use the definite article the with the superlative degree of adjectives. The example is, I heard the most interesting story. Here you can see the superlative degree is most interesting. So we use the before it. Next is, the Indus is the largest river of Pakistan. You can see that here I have used the before 2 things. Here Indus, it is the name or it is a proper noun. So I have used the before it. Like I have done in the first use, you can see here the Daily Dawn, the Mediterranean Sea. Similarly, the Indus. And I have used the before largest, because largest is the superlative degree of adjective. We will discuss the degrees of adjectives in my next lecture or another lecture. Now, hope you have understood till here very well. Now we have discussed the topics of today's lecture, but I want to give you a review for all of them, so that if any one of you have missed anything, you will understand it or listen it again. Some of the students are still continue joining me, so they are very late. Please keep in mind that from the next lecture, we will not permit you after the 10 minutes. So please, you should be there on time. This is the first lecture, so we are giving you some convenience that you are permitting for joining us at any time. But in the next lecture or from the next lectures, we will not allow you after 10 minutes. So please be cooperative and be attentive. And remember, you should join us with your real names, with your real IDs, and you should learn your roll numbers by your heart.
One teacher,
I am giving you, or I'm telling you again, that you are not allowed to leave the lecture before our permission. If you have any problem, you will inform us first and then you will leave for some time. So we will allow you to join us again. We have uploaded some rules to join online classes. Please go through them very clearly so that you will understand everything. These rules are uploaded on Google Classroom. Now I am giving you a quick review of my today's lecture. My topic is parts of speech. We have discussed 9 parts of speech. There are 9 parts of speech: noun, verb, pronoun, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection, and articles. Their definitions and examples have been discussed in detail previously, but now I am giving you a quick review. Noun is a name of person, place, animal, or thing. Some examples here are Ali, Karachi, Lion, Chair. These are examples for the person, place, animal, or thing. Some examples in the sentences forms are also given here. You can see that I have underlined some words, and these all are nouns. Ali is a good boy. Sara goes to school by bus. My school is very big. Pakistan is our dearest country. I respect my elders. Next is verb. A verb is a word which shows an action. Some examples are eat, drink, read, write, which all show some actions, like Ahmed reads a lesson. Sana learns a poem. He walks on the road. He prepares meal for the guest. They play cricket. All the underlined words here in the examples, they show some actions. So these are verbs. Next is pronoun. A pronoun is a word which is used in place of a noun. Like some pronouns given here, he, she, we, and they. He and she are used for the male and female persons respectively, and we and they are used for more than one person. Here, I have given some pronouns examples in the sentences form. He wrote a letter. He cleans the room. We are going to museum. You were telling a story. They were throwing balls. Next is adjective. An adjective is a word which tells something about a noun or a pronoun. You can see here, I have used some of the words here which are used as an adjective. And these are actually the describing words. Beautiful, active, bold, enough. Some examples are here. You can see that I have underlined all the describing words here. That means all the adjectives. Ahmed is a very kind man. Sarah is an intelligent student. The flower is beautiful. He tells an interesting story. She wore red dress. An adverb is a word which tells something about a verb. Like some words here, fast, early, sometimes, nearly. These words are describing the actions actually. So these are called adverbs. Some examples are given in the sentences form. Aisha walked slowly. Ali came early in the morning. The kitchen is downstairs. They will meet us soon. The children work hard. Now here you can see that there are different words which are underlined. They are all showing the adverbs because they are describing the verb which are given in the sentences. But there are different kinds of adverbs which we will discuss in our next lectures so that you will understand that how these adverbs are showing the description of the verbs. Next is preposition. I told you previously as well, the actual pronunciation is preposition, not the preposition. Please keep it in mind. A preposition is a word which is used before a noun or a pronoun to show its relation with another word. That means the preposition are those words which are showing the relations like with, from, into, behind. Many of the prepositions are there. We will discuss in the home assignment. Also, I will give you in different ways. Some examples are here. The teacher is writing with a pen. You can see that all the underlined words are showing the relations. Abdullah Irfan, please turn off your video. The frog jumped into the pond. The patient died of cancer. There is a park near my house. He is suffering from fever. Now these all words are showing the relations between the nouns and the with some other words given in the sentences. Here you can see that in the last example only there is a pronoun. Otherwise in all examples, we are giving you the examples of the nouns so that you will understand easily. Next is a conjunction is a word which joins two words and sentences. It means it is simply called a joining word. Some examples are and, but, because, although. There are some other conjunctions also, but I have given some examples here. Now here you can see that I have given examples of conjunctions in the sentences form so that you can understand more easily. She sold her car and bought a new one. It means the and conjunction is joining two sentences. She
sold her
car, she bought a new one. Similarly, in other examples, there are two sentences and these are joined by the word conjunction here. Different conjunctions are used for different sentences. He asked me a question, but I did not answer him. They might come or not come to school. Ali did not come because he was ill. Sana answered all questions, although she did not attend the class. Next is interjection. An interjection is a word which shows sudden feelings. As I have already told you, some words are used as interjections. Hurrah, wow, alas, oh. These are some of the words which are showing the interjections or showing feelings, but these do not have any particular meaning. These only show the feelings of happiness, sadness, any grief, any wonder, excitement. Like you can see that here in the example. Hurrah, I have got first position. Wow, the meal is very delicious. Alas, the patient has died. Oh, I forgot my coffee. Ah, my friend has lost her parents. These are some of the words which are showing the feelings. Some words, why and how, are showing the feelings of happiness. And others, alas, oh, ah, these all are showing the feeling of sadness.
Teacher?
This article, which is also included in the
part teacher.
Of speech, there are two kinds of articles, indefinite article, a and an, definite article, the. I have given some uses and examples of these articles because these are used differently in different sentences. We have discussed the use of indefinite article, that A is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant. You should know about all the consonant letters. Like, I purchased a new car here. I have given the example in which the consonant words are used. We take a glass of milk daily. Here you can see the consonant words N and G are here. Next use is A is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel which has a consonant sound. So keep it in mind that A is also used with some vowels, but they should have the consonant sounds. Like, she studied in a university. You can see that university starts with U, but it gives a consonant sound of Y. He is a European. Similarly, it gives the sound of consonant, although it starts with a vowel. We have also discussed the use of indefinite article an here. An is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel. There are only 5 vowels. You should remember them, A, E, I, O, U. My friend takes an egg in breakfast. There's an ink pot on the table. You can see that here, egg word starts with the vowel E, ink pot starts with the vowel I. So we have used and before them. And it's used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant which has a vowel sound. Again, keep it in mind, and is used for some consonants, words, but if they should have a vowel sound, like he's an MA in English, MSc in chemistry, you can see that both the words MA and MSc starts with these are starting with the consonant word, but they give the sound of vowel A.
Teacher.
Jabbar, you are so much late. Use of definite article the is used before a proper noun. And I read the Daily Dawn. The Mediterranean Sea is sometimes rough. You can see that the is used before the proper nouns, Daily Dawn and Mediterranean Sea. The is also used before the superlative degrees of adjectives. Like here you can see the, I heard the most interesting story. The Indus is the largest river of Pakistan. Here you can see the most interesting and the largest. These two are the superlative degrees of adjectives. We will discuss the degrees of adjectives in our upcoming lectures. This is a quick review of the lecture. Now I think you have understood it all. So I want to end my lecture here.
Teacher? Miss Miss.
Now I am permitting you to ask some questions. If you have got any confusions, you are allowed
teacher
to ask some questions, but one by one.
Teacher.
After 2 minutes, I will start asking questions. If you have any query, any problem, any question, just ask me.
Teacher, टीचर आपका ये यूट्यूब चैनल का नाम क्या है?
Now all of you are allowed to ask questions. First of all, unmute yourself first, so that you can ask any questions. One by one, you can ask any question.
Miss,
teacher,
okay. Now, please come on chair. You can write anything, any question, so that I will answer you. Walaikum assalam. You all are welcome here to the first online class. Do you want to ask anything?
No.
Now it is the time for you. If you want to ask anything, please write here so that I can see and answer you. You have limited time. You have Shaheed Junaid, you have written here. I did not buy any copy, so please buy them as soon as possible. Buy them, but we will give you some time or some date so that you can come and buy them. When we will give you the assignment, you will complete them in the copies. Ask in the call in the school, and then ask. They will give you the date to buy the copies. Okay. My YouTube channel name is with my own name, Mrs. Afshin Imran. You can get the upload of this lecture from there.
Miss,
who have not understood articles N and A, please. Okay, I will give the quick review in afterwards as well in my other lectures, and you can get the lecture from the link. We will upload the link on Google Classroom, and from where you can get the lecture from the YouTube channel, so that you will understand it from the lecture. Repeat it again and again so that you will understand. My YouTube channel name is with my name again. My name is Mrs. Afshin Imran. I have discussed the articles A and N again and again in my lecture twice or thrice. So you can get this knowledge from the video.
Miss?
And actually, I'm giving you a quick review again that A and N are actually the indefinite articles. I think you have got the problem here that where they are used. These have some particular use. A is used with the consonant words actually. But sometimes they are also used with the vowels. Some vowels are giving us the consonant sounds. So we use the word A or article A from with them. Similarly, N is the article which is used for particularly for the vowels, but sometimes they are also used for the consonant words. That means some of the vowels, some of the consonant words which are giving the vowel sound. So you can see the examples in the lecture so that you will understand more. Copies are not available here now, but we are giving you the date and they will be available soon here. So call in this. These are available in the bookshop actually. All the copies are available in the bookshop. Go there and find out them. No, I'm not giving you today any written homework because you are not having the copies. So I'm giving you time to take the copies. After that, I will give you the written homework. I will give you some learning homework today. Find out in Google Classroom.
Miss?
You are all welcome every time. Any other thing which you want to ask? Because the time is over, I am going to end my lecture.
Miss,
learning homework will be uploaded soon.
Miss, ये आपके उसमें सही तरह से वो नहीं आ रहा.
Check it in the Google Classroom. Okay. Now, thank you all. I am ending my lecture here. I am ending my lecture here. Hope you have understood it very clearly. Repeat it when you download the lecture from the YouTube channel so that you will understand more. I am leaving here and inshallah we will meet in the next lecture. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.
तैयार हो गए.